Hey kids, cover your kids' ears if they're here. Today we're making Slutty Brownies.
It's YouTube's best for creative things. It's cooking and crafting.
Hey kids. I have my little helper Bane coming this way with me today. He's not feeling well, so he is going to be helping me today fix these sinfully awesome brownies. The first thing we're going to do is we're going to put together the brownie mix. And this one, pretty much, you don't have to have any ingredients other than the stuff that you're putting together for your brownies. So whatever your brownies ask, yeah, you can taste. Whatever your brownies ask for, that is what you are going to need. Ours, we're going to do the fudgy brownies. So we're going to use one large egg, a third cup of water, and a third cup of oil. So we're just going to go ahead, add all of that in.
Hello.
And my wonderful little sick assistant is going to help me put this together. Then we're going to set
it up.
Yeah, we're going to have to, not, we're going to clean that up after. Then we're going to take care of that and we'll be back. The next thing you need is 1 pound of chocolate chip cookie dough. These are the, you know, the ready-made ones. You can, of course, make your own recipe for your own brownies or use your own recipe for your own chocolate chip cookies, which probably will taste 800 times better than, you know, the already made ones. We are going to add in these Valentine's Day sprinkles.
Can I take one?
Sure.
It looks good.
Mm-hmm. And we're just going to massage it in and make this, try to make this one great big ball of dough. Ooh, and of course, because it's just, put that into the sink if you're gonna help. You have to wash your hands as well. Auntie already washed her hands, so you're gonna have to wash your hands, but we're gonna have to really massage this in well because it just got out of the refrigerator, so it is quite hard and cold. And then once we get that massaged, we are going to stick this into a 9x13 pan. Okay, well, you know what? I guess I don't need your help getting this in there anymore because I've pretty much got it in there. We're going to go put this into a 9x13 pan. I've preheated my oven to 350 degrees. See? Told you. What I actually need to line the bottom of this with parchment paper. Okay, I'm going with the wet hand mode. Go ahead, press, use your muscle, Russell, and press it down. Press it all the way down. Can you do it? Do you need some of my help?
I need that.
No, that'll work. That'll work. I promise. All right, we'll be back once we have that pressed down into the bottom of this pan, even if it needs a little bit of Auntie's help. Here's the technical difficulties that come into play when you do a recipe. I saw someone do a recipe using, it said, the recipe itself said to use an 8x8 pan. But when they put it together, they used a 9x13 pan. And every other recipe I've ever seen online, they used a 9x13 pan. But this 16-ounce cookie dough will not stretch out for any amount into a 9x13 pan. So that's why it's always good to use your spidey instincts, right, Bane?
Mm-hmm.
And do what your gut tells you to do and not what all the recipes that are out there online tell you to do. So, like I said, we've switched over. We're using an 8x8 pan. And once I get this all in there, we're moving on to our next step. We'll be right back. The next step is we are going to put in some mega stuffed Oreo cookies. There you go. Thanks. Yeah. Now, what? You, there will be leftovers you can eat later, not now. Why is it that you can't eat anything until it comes to junk? Okay, put it inside and I'll show you what. We're going to stagger it. So put it there.
I want to put it
like
this.
Wait. Yes, exactly. We're gonna put one up, one down, one up, one down, okay? Hopefully there's gonna be some leftovers. So we're gonna kind of stagger it because the next layer that we're gonna put on means anything that's not covered, that next layer is going to seep down into, okay? So let's go, we're gonna take care of that and we'll be right back. Well, I lost my assistant when I told him that he couldn't eat what was left over of that third pack plus all of these. He's sick. His stomach is upset. Of course not. Silly little guy. Now those brownies come back into play. We are going to cover this all with the brownies. And we're going to stick that into the... Whoa, that's awesome. Into the 350 degree oven for 30 to 35 gross. Minutes. You think that's gross?
Weird.
You think it's weird?
Oh no, it opened.
It's okay. There we go.
Do it?
Okay. You want to smooth it? I moved you a little further away.
Why?
Well, because you weren't going to be here, so why should I have your little stool in front of me? Let's see what's going to happen here. See, isn't that wonderful? Up and out with no issues whatsoever. Now we're going to take off the parchment. We are going to slide that over onto our cutting board ever so gently. Now, you can take it one step further. You can put some chocolate covering. Oh, maybe some Nutella. Ganache. Something interesting. I don't know that I want to go that over the top because I might be a little bit on the floozy side, but I'm sure not super, super. get your kids out of the room. Slutty. And here we go. Let's open it up and see what it says. Let me move you closer, closer. It looks ooey. It looks gooey. It looks yummy full. Let's see what it tastes like. I decided why not. Let's go ahead and do this. I made it in a la mode. Ice cream is really cold. The brownies are still a little warm and gooey and fudgy chewy. Yeah, I think I'm going to rename this Sinful Brownies because the word slutty kind of doesn't fit with my channel, but hey. I bow down. I didn't think this was going to be very good because I was like, Oreos in the middle? That, my friends, do it. It took me about 50 to 55 minutes, however, to cook, okay? Or bake. Enjoy.
Thank you for watching Cooking and Crafting. Before we have to say goodbye, make sure you comment and subscribe.
We won't talk about poops on the camera, okay?